We have gathered in this lovely, lovely garden on this beautiful Sunday afternoon to be joyful and to celebrate the relationship of Dawn and Seth. By their commitment to marry each other, they're saying yes to life. They're saying it's good to be alive and to breathe the fresh air and to feel the rays of the golden California sun right up there, and to hold each other close and to be with wonderful family and friends together in caring and in love. Won't you please be seated? And now on this absolutely lovely day, just a little bit warm, what is it, about 114? A little bit warm. I ask who presents this woman to be married to this nervous guy.
Well? Me, her mother, and I.
Thank you both.
Okay. Okay, son.
I want to welcome everybody here on behalf of Dawn and Seth to their wedding ceremony. And I look at their faces and I see expression of joy and happiness. Maybe a little happiness and joy. I want you to see those beautiful faces. I'm going to invite them to turn around and face you so they can enjoy you, enjoy them, become husband and wife. So I'll just have you turn all the way around. Now you take a good look at this couple and let me know if you suggest that those with the parasol, if you'll lift the mic in time so people behind you are able to see, that would be fabulous. Thank you so much. Everybody here is family, close and caring friends. Dawn and Seth are so clean that you need to notice look how clean they look. Don't they look clean? Look clean. Look clean. That's good. He's clean. And they're thrilled to have you here for Dawn, our parents, Claude and Judy. Loving couple, been married for well over, your daughter said, over 30 years? Dad says 130. Yeah. They are happy together. They're each other's best friend. They enjoy retirement years. They travel a lot. They are living the good life. Mom, you've been a great mother. Dawn knows she can count on you. No matter what, you're always there with lots and lots of love. She told me you should talk on the phone several times a week. And you and Dad live in Colorado, and that's so special to have that happen. Dad, you've been one awesome father. You've been kind, supportive. You went to her game. You even attended the father-daughter dance.
Yeah.
That's right. You're kind and wise and full of great advice. And she was thrilled, Dad, to have you escort her down the aisle. Now, brother Ethan, twin brother Ethan, is here. He's a terrific brother.
There he is.
Yep. He is minutes older, and he thinks he's about an hour wiser than his sister. Yeah. And both the bride and groom are pleased to have you standing up as best man. And you brought your special partner, Allie, and where's she?
She's over. Where's Allie?
Okay. Dawn told me the two of you are very happy together. That's right. Now, the bridal party for Dawn is your wonderful close friend, Allie, as our matron of honor. You two have been through the good and the even better together. She knows she can count on you. Your sweet husband, Robert, is here. He's one of our ushers. Which one is Robert? There he is, back there. Okay, back there. How do you get that done? And our bridesmaids are Allie, our brother's girlfriend, along with Michelle, Laura, and Julia. And all of you are sweet and women of grace and sweetness. And Dawn is truly honored to have each one of you here for her. And here for Seth is his wonderful mother, Betty Jo, actually. And your son said you're very kind. Yeah. And he said you're the kind of mother who loves your sons no matter what. And you love them 100%. 110%, Mom said. Your son told me you're fantastic. You're always there. When he was in high school, he went to some of the games that he played in. He went to his play. And when he was sent to the principal's office, you went down there with it, too. Seth loves and honors you, Mom, so much. Now, Seth is not the only child. He has two terrific brothers. He has brother Brett and brother Kirk. And we're at brother in our life. Brett and Kirk? Good. And they're awesome. Here's what he said. You're awesome. Which one's awesome? Awesome and fabulous. Maybe they're both.
I might be quick, though.
Brett came out from Pennsylvania, and Kirk might be going down from Georgia to be here for their brother. And Seth feels close to you both, and wish you both live close. And he calls you both fantastic human beings. He says you both are part of a great and loving family. Now, Seth has five groomsmen, men for the ages. Best man is his good buddy, and officially his brother, too, and we're talking about Ethan. And then, that's five, so twin brothers. And then Seth loves and respects you, Ethan. He's on to have his family close to him. Did you remember the name? Oh, good. Okay, good. Our four groomsmen, we got Danny, we got John, we got Jason, and we got Aaron. Most of these guys are dating or are engaged to members of the bridal party on this side, except Aaron. This is Aaron. Aaron is tall, tan, rested, and available. Not available. You know, a lot of folks here we haven't mentioned by name, but you're all family. They're going to have a wonderful reception in just a few minutes. They hope you'll all stay for that. They're going to have good food. They're going to have some dancing, right?
A little bit.
A little bit of dancing.
Yeah.
And it's going to be a wonderful time. They hope everyone will stay for every minute of that fun. It'll be cool where the reception's going to be. The party will be in a cool place, but they're going to make it hot as the evening goes on. But right now, I want to share with everybody a little bit about why Dawn and Seth are standing here with these big, big smiles, big smiles on their faces. That's right. You know, they met about 9 years ago, and the connection was very strong. They both lived in an apartment complex in San Marcos, and they happened to be next-door neighbors. Dawn was listening to heavy metal while cleaning her house. Seth, along with Buddy and groomsman Jason over there, heard the metal sound, and since they both were car-carrying metal heads, they knocked on the door to find out who the band was. Dawn came to the door, and the first thing she thought was, I'm going to call security. I mean, the guys had long hair, they were black, wearing black clothes, it was a little shocking. But soon they began to smile and be their warm, natural selves and act neatly. And before long, Seth and Dawn began to smile even more when they would see each other around the complex. Sometimes they talk, and then sometimes they go out for a kind of a hangout, casual date, getting to know each other. At first they thought what they were doing was just hanging out. But slowly, Seth began to know in his heart that Dawn was super suspicious. Right. And while there was no certain day they became a couple, on Christmas Eve of 2009, Seth proposed. They were up in Colorado. He was going to put the ring up on top of the snowman that he was building. But it was too much, the snow was too much like powder, and it wouldn't hold its form. And so he just paddled down in the snow, got the ring out of his pocket, and he wouldn't let her up until she said yes. You know that, don't you?
I am very well.
Very well, 200 that. I wanted to know why Seth wants Dawn to be his lunchtime partner, and he said, well, first of all, can we get Dawn and Seth outside so I can talk to you in confidence? And I think it's a ring thing. So Dawn went outside. And Seth said, you know, there are so many things that I love about Dawn. To me, she is the definition of a pure heart, beautiful inside and out. She's a constant giver with nothing but good intentions every second of the day. She's real, she's genuine, she's open, honest, beautiful. And have I mentioned, he said, that I think Dawn is very easy on the eye. She is so thoughtful and kind, everything good. She thinks more about others around her rather than her own personal gain. She is such a true friend to everyone. And yet she also loves herself enough to take the time for herself. She gets to do and endure all the things that she wants. She and I, so said, have talked about what is important in life. And we both agree and we try to live holding people as most important. People are more important over money, over fame, over huge buildings. The relationships we make endure, Seth was saying. The bottom line is that I consider Don to be a magnificent person that everyone can learn from. I know I have learned so much myself from Don. I feel that we have been each other's teachers in many ways. And besides this, Don's a lot of fun to be with. We are 100% honest and open. We can get goofy and silly. We can be serious. And we live in an environment of joy together. Not bad, eh? Then you said you respect Don so much. You said she's a very good job. She's very organized. She helps out anyone in the office space. She knows exactly what she is doing. And anytime other staff members need some help, she is there to help get them. She is a problem solver. Her co-workers respect her. Her friends respect her. No one seems to like be liked by everyone else except Don. Everyone likes and respects this woman. Everyone invites Don to every party that they have, any activity, because she's so pure of heart that everyone wants to be around her. Maybe my friends get more of my attention, Seth said, than I give Don, because I do want to change the world and I want to make everyone's life better. Sometimes I'm there so much for my friends, I give much of my good energy to them. And when I come to Don, my reservoir of goodness is kind of down a little bit. But I still give her ultimate love, and I know in reverse, she knows that my love is real, you know that? She knows that, that's called communication. Someday we want to have some babies, and I know Dawn will be a fantastic mother. She has been a nanny, and she has a mother, and she has that mother thing Dawn has. And by the way, we have the two of us, we have two dogs. We have a Basset Hound named Charlotte and a Boston Terrier named Gulliver. Now, they both give their approval to this unit. And both dogs like Don more. Then we sent Seth out of the room for a little while, and I asked Don why she said yes to us in the snow. And she said, you know, I can sense the humor. He can laugh at himself, he can make me laugh, he is good with his finances. And you know, knowing that, I feel secure. On the cute view, I put this man at the very top. He is a perfect 10. He is adorable. That ought to be worth a little kiss. That's adorable. You want to give him a little kiss? He is compassionate, and a special quality I've seen him develop over the years is that his compassion for others keeps growing. He cares about everyone and connects with him or her in their own particular walk of life, and then they are where they are on their journey. He wants to help other people. He has the capacity to feel other people's pain. Oh, does that sound like the boy you raised?
Well, good, we right on, aren't we?
He doesn't wear his emotions on his sleeve, but he's certainly strong, has strong emotions, and is feeling and is caring now. Now, Seth has many friends, and yet he makes space in his life for us, I'm sure. We have many of the same friends. We're so often together with friends, we're like a big family. Yet I always know Seth puts me first, and that our relationship is most special. I have a lot of respect for Seth. At the workplace, he is on top of his game. He never calls in sick, ever. He's conscientious. He is a hard worker. He's dedicated to doing best. His best. He takes his work seriously. He gives his company full measure and tries to go better in his work, and he takes pride in what he does. His colleagues and his co-workers all respect him, and they know they can ask him a question anytime, and guess what? He will know the answer.
Can I ask you questions about my son?
Do you want to keep making money? Oh, we'll talk later. Now, Boyce said, we want to have a family, and I know that Seth would be a good father and parent. He might be a bit scared of that often responsibility, but he has a caring attitude, and I know he would be the best parent. Now, you can look at this couple, and you know they're looking, but they love to have a good time. You know what they like to do? They like to go camping. They'll drop the friend, for a nice dinner. They like watching cooking shows on TV. They love concerts and movies, and they love traveling, and they love family. So mom and dad, if you decide to have a gathering, and mom is going to have to kind of get together, they're going to try their best to be there because they love family. You know, I spent some time with this couple. I think they're ready, but I said, I want to hear from you on this is why you believe you like them instead of. Now look at Seth, and she says, Seth, you're an amazing and caring man, you're kind, you're thoughtful. You're very intelligent, and the smartest thing you'll ever do is marry me. I'm right for you. By marrying me, you get someone who is stable, someone who appreciates your sense of humor, someone who will always be excited to be married to you, and I love you your whole life. And Seth said, Dawn, you are getting absolutely the best deal in town by marrying me. Because I am a genius. A person, a people-oriented person. I'm a leader. I take charge of things. I design us, you and me, in a positive and loving direction. And our life and our family are off to a positive and beautiful lifetime adventure and dream. And I love you very, very much. I'm going to ask you if you give your bouquet to Allie, your niece and Bonnie, who's coming over here. And then turn and face each other and hold each other with both hands. That's good. Would you mind if I step over there and get a sip of water?
Okay, I'll be right back. Not from the waterfall, right? It does look professional.
But as you sit here looking at your family and your friends, I know you had wonderful feelings in your heart that I hope you always do. But I want you to know that marriage is a commitment. Marriage is a partnership. When you enter into a partnership, you agree and you commit to bringing a profound respect to that agreement, to that partner, to you, Seth, and to you, Dawn. So I urge you both here at the altar where in just a few minutes, you will begin that journey through life as committed partners, that you live out that profound respect for one another by being fair, by doing your share, and always taking care of yourself, taking care of each other, and most of all, your precious partnership. We call that love. And I think you are well on the way to mastering the art of loving yourself, and loving each other. I think you're willing to do the hard work and done things every day to protect this investment that you've been making in each other. Remember, I said this is a good job, good job, a good person, and a partner, a good job, a good partner. Remember that? Well, a good way to remind yourselves of how difficult this job is that no matter where you are, you might be taking the dogs for a walk, or maybe you're over at Costco shopping, or walking on the beach, and somebody walks up and they look at you and they say, well, Dawn, what do you do? Well, Seth, what is it that you do? I want you to look them right in the eye, give them a big smile, and say, you know, I am about the business of building a lifetime partnership with my son. That's what I do. You know the greatest thing you'll ever learn is just to love and to let yourself be well in the future. Seth, are you ready now to play two times to go?
I have to.
Go on, are you ready to exchange vows with
him? Absolutely.
As you prepare your hearts and your minds for the exchange vows, let me share with you the scripture reading. God is very patient and kind. It's never jealous or envious. It's never boastful or proud. It's never fancy or selfish or mean. Love does not demand its own way. It's not irritable or affecting. It does not hold grudges, and will hardly even notice when others do wrong. Never glad about injustice, but it rejoices when it is true. If you love someone, you've been holding him
or her,
no matter what the cost. You'll always believe in her or him. You'll always expect the best of him or her, and you will always stand your ground in defending him or her. You know, all the special gifts and powers of God someday will come to an end. The love goes on. Dawn and Seth are so pleased and honored to be exchanging marriage vows in front of friends, family, and in the presence of God. Seth, as you look into Dawn's eyes, you see that to me.
I accept.
Commit my life.
Commit my life.
To our partnership in marriage.
To our partnership in marriage.
Dawn, I promise.
Dawn, I promise.
To comfort you.
To comfort you.
To encourage you.
To encourage you.
I promise.
And I promise.
To express my thoughts.
To express my thoughts.
And my emotions.
And my emotions.
To you.
To you.
And to listen to you.
And to listen to you.
Maybe you should say that again. And to listen to me.
And to listen to me.
In times of joy.
In times of joy.
And in times of sorrow.
And in times of sorrow.
John, you're my best friend.
John, you're my best friend.
I love you.
I love you.
I shall be honored.
I shall be honored.
To call you.
To call you.
I'm the one. You did good. And you take a deep breath, look in the Seth's eyes, and see that in your eye, Mom.
I can.
Commit my life.
Commit my life.
To our partnership in marriage.
To our partnership in marriage.
Seth, I promise to comfort you.
Seth, I promise to comfort you.
To encourage you.
To encourage you.
I promise.
I promise.
To express my thoughts.
To express my thoughts.
And my emotions.
And my emotions.
To you.
To you.
And to listen to you.
To listen to you.
In times of joy.
In times of joy.
And in times of sorrow.
And in times of sorrow.
Seth, you are my best friend.
Seth, you are my best friend.
I love you.
I
should be honored.
I should be honored.
To call you.
To call you.
Now, may I please have the ring? Now, I want you both to look at those rings for just a moment. You know, from the earliest of times, the circle has been a symbol of completeness, a symbol of committed love. An unbroken and never-ending circle symbolizes a commitment of love that is also never-ending. And I hope that every time either one of you look at the symbol that you're going to wear in your hand, you'll be reminded of this vow of commitment to love each other forever that you're making at this very time. Seth, as you look in your mom's eyes and as you place the ring right there on your knees, repeat after me. I, Seth.
Give you God.
This ring.
This ring.
To wear upon your hand.
To wear upon your hand.
As a symbol. Of my committed love to you.
Of my committed love to you.
And of our unity.
And of our unity.
Love. How's that feel?
Feels good.
Now, before we have the new person in the room, I'd like to have our gentleman.
Pretty hot out here.
Now, as you look in the Seth's eyes and as you place the ring right there on his hand, repeat after me. I don't give you Seth. This ring,
okay.
Wear upon your hand,
as a symbol
of my committed love to you,
and of our unity.
Now we're going to have a very special part of the ceremony, the blending of sins. I'm going to ask our groom to escort his bride, and we'll have the best man help me lift this table out a little bit so we'll have enough room for someone to get behind us. So you left the room right around here. On this table are two vases, each with a different color of sand. In the center, there's another larger vase, and that represents the new family
that our couple created by their marriage. These two veils are failing, but that's the difference. Represent the two families being joined by this marriage. So I'm going to invite the two of you, Seth first, pour some foundation layer of cancer into this container. Blend a little bit more sand in there. What they're actually doing is they're blending these two sands because they're blending their two lives and the families that were responsible for loving them and nurturing them and bringing them to the point where they are, the people they are. And they're going to continue to pour until they fill that center base. And then I think they're going to take that base to the reception area so you can all look at it. When you look at it, you will be reminded that each one of you is represented by the blended sand in that beautiful vase. Then they're going to take it to their home and keep it in a place of honor, always reminding them that on this day, they become an official household of this community. Thank you. Now, after you drive right back to the altar. Oh, that is so lovely. You'll want to be sure to give that a nice good look. Back at this point and face each other once again. Take a nice deep breath. By the authority of the state of California vested in me and on the foundation of your commitment one to the other, I now pronounce you Seth and Dawn husband and wife. Seth, you may kiss the ground.
Thank you.